Good morning to everyone. See, in the last class we have seen the response of a first order system and second order system, right? See, in this class I am going to explain time domain specifications of control systems. See, mainly the desired performance characteristics of the control systems are specified in terms of these time domain specifications. Here, time domain specifications are mainly one is a delay time, and second one is rise time, and third one is peak time, and fourth one is maximum overshoot, and the last one is settling time. See, the performance characteristics of the control systems. A system which may have any error, but its performance may be specified in terms of the transient response to a unit step input signal. See, here I am taking the response of second order system for unit step input with different values of damping ratio. See, the corresponding response of the system, that is second order system, you may see in figure 3.13b. See, here I have here we are considering a unit step input, right? That is as shown figure 3.13a, that is the unit step input. The corresponding response of the second order system for different damping ratio, which is showing figure, that is 3.13b. Okay, see, mainly the transient response of a system, that is a control system, for a unit step input mainly depends upon the initial conditions. Okay, here the figure 3.14, it shows the damped oscillatory response of second order system for unit step input, that is figure 3.14. Here mainly the response of a practical control system which exhibits the damped oscillations before it reaches to steady state, right? See, from the figure 3.13, here we have oscillations, right? From the starting point, that is zero, from zero to at certain point, that is TS, settling time, there is oscillations, right? After that, the response, the transient response of the control system, which goes to the steady state. See, which is clearly we may see in figure 3.13. See, the main transient response characteristics of the control system to unit step input, which is specified in terms of the time domain specifications. So these five are the time domain specifications. Those are, one is delay time, and second one is rise time, third one is peak time, and fourth one is maximum overshoot, and the last one is settling time. See, from this damped oscillatory response of second order system for unit step input, here we see, you may see where TD is the delay time, and TR is the rise time, and TP is the peak time, and MP, okay, that is MP is the maximum overshoot, and then final one is settling time, that is TA. See, the main these time domain specifications are defined as, there is the first one, delay time is defined as, it is the time taken for the response to reach 50% of the final value for the very first time. See, here one is the my final value. So according to delay time definition, see, it is the time taken for the response to reach 50%. So that is 0.5, right? 50% of the final value for the very first time. So this is the definition for delay time. So the second one is rise time. Here from this gap graph, from this response here, rise time TR. So it is defined as it is the time taken for the response to rise from 0 to 100% for the first very time. If we are considering, if we take 100 ampere system, then the rise time is calculated from 0 to 100%. In case of over damper system, it is, that is, the rise time is taken from 10% to 90%. For the critical damper system, the time taken for the response to rise from 5% to 95%. See, for different systems, here rise time is vary. Okay. Once again, for 100 ampere system, the rise time is calculated from 0 to 100%. In case of over damper system, the time taken by the response to rise from 90% to, sorry, 10% to 90%. For critically damper system, the time taken for response to rise from 5% to 95%. So that is about rise time, that is TR. And third one is here peak time. So TP is the peak time. It is the time taken for the response to reach the peak value the very first time. Okay, here TP is the peak time. Here the third one, it is TP. Okay, here y-axis at CTP, the response corresponding response at TP, CTP finally. See, it's simply defined as it's the time taken for the response to reach the peak overshoot, that is MP. Then it's called peak time. And then the fourth one is maximum overshoot, that is MP. Maximum overshoot. See, it is defined as the ratio of maximum peak value to the final value. Okay, simply it is the ratio of maximum peak value to final value, where the maximum peak value is measured from the final value. Here, see, here C of infinity, we assumed that C of infinity is the final value of C of T and C of TP. So it is the maximum value of CT. So finally, peak overshoot MP is equal to C of TP minus C of infinity divided by whole divided by C of infinity. So the equation 3.37 represents the ratio of maximum peak value to the final value. Okay, so the percentage of peak overshoot, that is percentage of MP, equal to C of TP minus C of infinity whole divided by C of infinity into 100. So this is peak overshoot. And the next one is settling time. So TS is the settling time. It is defined as the time taken by the response to reach and stay within a specified error. Okay, the time taken by the response to reach and stay within a specified error. So it is called settling time. Usually, settling time is expressed as a percentage of final value. So the usual tolerable error for settling time is 2% or 5% of the final value. So settling time is simply defined as the time taken by the response to reach and stay within a specified error. So simply it is called as settling time. See, the next topic is the expressions for the time domain specifications. See, here for all these time domain specifications, we are going to find out the expressions. Okay, first one is rise time. In order to calculate the expression for rise time, we are considering the unit step response of second order system for underdamped case. Okay, see, in previous cases we have seen how to calculate the response of second order system for different zeta values, right? There we are find out the response of the second order system for underdamped system, underdamped case, right? Okay, from that we are taking this unit step response of second order system for underdamped case, that is C of t equal to 1 minus e to the power minus theta omega n t by square root of 1 minus zeta square into sine omega t plus theta. See, here we are going to find out the expression for rise time, right? So simply we are assumed at t equal to tr, okay, just at rise time. So at particular rise time, that is t equal to tr, my response of the second order system, that is c of t, is equal to c of tr, that equal to 1. So now substitute c of t equal to 1 in the first equation. So therefore c of tr equal to 1 minus e power minus zeta omega n t tr by square root of 1 minus zeta square sine omega t tr plus theta, that equal to 1. So simply replace c of t by c of tr, as well as the value of ct is equal to 1. So simply cancel plus 1. Simply cancel 1 on both sides, okay? And then we have minus e power minus zeta omega n tr by square root of 1 minus zeta square sine omega t tr plus theta, that equal to 0, okay? Just take out the denominator term to the right side, simply 0 into square root of 1 minus zeta square, that is 0. Okay. At the same time, minus e to the power minus zeta omega n tr, which is that is not equal to 0. Right. So simply the term sine omega t tr plus theta, that is 0. This is sine omega d theta r plus theta, that equal to 0. See, simply which is in the form of sine pi equal to 0. So sine pi equal to 0 means pi value may be 0 or pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, and so on. So multiples of pi. So now simply pi equal to 0. So the value of pi, nothing but previously we are taken that omega d tr plus theta, we are assumed the term omega d tr plus theta, that is pi. So simply the value of pi may be 0, pi, 2 pi, and so on. So pi is equal to pi. So pi value is omega d tr plus theta, which equal to pi, pi pi. So finally find out omega d tr, which equal to pi minus theta. So from that rise time tr equal to pi minus theta by omega d. So this is the rise time here. See, on constructing a right angle triangle with zeta and square root of 1 minus zeta square, we have the value, that is tan theta equal to square root of 1 minus zeta square by zeta, that is opposite side by adjacent side. So from that right angle triangle, we have theta equal to tan inverse of square root of 1 minus zeta square by zeta. So we know that a damped frequency of oscillation, that is omega d, equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square, where omega n is the natural damped frequency. So simply substitute theta value in rise time equation, that is tr equal to pi minus theta by omega d. So pi minus, substitute theta, that is tan inverse of square root of 1 minus zeta square by zeta, whole divided by omega d. So damped frequency of oscillation, that is omega d equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. So this is the expression for rise time. Here the theta value should be measured in radians. So the next one is peak time. So the next topic is, we are going to find out the expression for peak time. So in order to find out the expression for peak time, we have to differentiate C of t with respect to t and then equate to zero. Okay. Differentiate C of t at t equal to 0, sorry, at t equal to tp, because peak time, and then equal to 0. Okay, see here also we are considering the unit step response of underdamped second order system, that is C of t equal to 1 minus e power minus zeta omega n t by square root of 1 minus zeta square into sin omega d t plus theta. Okay, so now differentiating that C of t with respect to t. See, finally, if we differentiate C of t with respect to t, and then put the value of omega d equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. See, just do differentiation, you have the final equation, that is omega n by square root of 1 minus zeta square e power minus zeta omega n t is multiplied with sine of omega d t plus theta minus theta whole brackets for sine only, that equal to omega n by square root of 1 minus zeta square e power minus zeta omega n t sine omega d t. Okay, now replace t by tp and then equate the differential, that is d by dt of c of t equal to 0. Okay, so simply equate omega n by square root of 1 minus zeta square into e power minus zeta omega n tp sin omega d tp, that equals 0. So here also, finally we have the term, that is sin omega d tp equal to 0, which is in the form of just assume omega d tp phi. So sin phi equal to 0, nothing but the value of phi equal to, is taken as pi, value of phi equal to pi, pi pi. So omega d tp equal to pi. So simply peak time, that is tp equal to pi by omega d. Here the damped frequency of oscillation omega d equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. So substitute the value of omega d in peak time, that is tp equal to pi by omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. So this is the expression for peak time. See, this is the expression for peak time, tp equal to pi by omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. And the next one is peak overshoot, that is MP. See, here we are going to find out the expression for peak overshoot. From the definition of peak overshoot, that is percentage of peak overshoot, percentage of MP equal to C of TP minus C of infinity by C of infinity into 100. So nothing but ratio of maximum peak value to final value. Okay, where C of TP equal to peak response at T equal to TP, and C of infinity is the final steady state value. Okay, here also we are considering the unit step response of second order system. Okay, so C of t that equal to 1 minus e power minus zeta omega n t by root of 1 minus zeta square sine omega d t plus theta. Okay, so at t equal to infinity, find out the response. At the same time at t equal to tp, find out the response, that is C of t, and then substitute in equation 3.43, that is in order to get the expression of peak overshoot, substitute in the its definition itself. Okay, that is percentage of peak overshoot, percentage of MP equal to C of TP minus C of infinity by C of infinity into 100. So first initial find out C of TP value and then C of infinity, substitute in that equation. So simply substitute, finally percentage peak value, that is percentage MP equal to C of TP minus C of infinity by C of infinity 100, that equal to C of TP value is 1 minus C of TP value is 1 plus e power minus zeta pi by square root of 1 minus zeta square. And C of infinity value is 1 by C of infinity, so 1. So substitute value of C of 1. So finally, we have the percentage peak overshoot value e power minus zeta pi by square root of 1 minus zeta square into 100. So this is peak overshoot expression. So the next one is expression for settling time, that is TS. See here settling time mainly here also second order system has mainly two components. One is decaying exponential component, that is e power minus zeta omega n t by square of 1 minus zeta square, and the second component is sinusoidal component, that is sine omega t plus theta. Okay. See here, the decaying component term, which reduces the oscillations produced by this sinusoidal component. So that's why the settling time is decided by the exponential component. So the settling time is decided by the second one, that is the first one, that is exponential component. So the settling time can be found out by equating the exponential component to percentage tolerance errors. So here initially we are see that we are already seen that see settling time usually has tolerable error, that is 2% is 2% or 5% of the final value, right? So here we are going to equating the exponential component to the percentage tolerance errors. So that is one is 2% tolerance error case, and second one is 5% tolerance error case. So in first case, at t equal to t s, for 2% tolerance error band, so that is equal to e power minus zeta omega n ts by square of 1 minus zeta square. So simply at t equal ts, replace the term t by ts in the decaying exponential component. Okay, for 2% tolerance error band case. For here for least values of zeta, so e power minus zeta omega n ts, which equal to, so here we are considering 2% tolerance error, right? So simply 2% means 0.02. So taking natural logarithm on both sides, so then left hand side becomes minus zeta omega n ts is equal to, we are taking a natural logarithm, right? So ln of 0.02. So finally we have ts equal to 4 by zeta omega n omega m. Okay, for the second order system we have the time constant t equal to 1 by zeta omega m. So finally ts equal to 1 by zeta omega m, which is equal to 40 for 2% error tolerable error case. The settling time ts equal to 40. Similarly for 5% tolerance error case, so we are here also we just equating the exponential component, that is e power minus zeta omega n t by square root of 1 minus zeta square. So this is the decaying exponential component. So we are going to equating this component to the percentage tolerance error. So that is in the next case. So in this case equating to 5% error. So e power minus zeta omega n ts, which is equal to 0.05. So here also taking natural logarithm on both sides. So then we have ts, that is settling time, equal to 3 by zeta omega n. So nothing but, which is equal to 3t for 5% error case. See. Finally, the general for specified percentage error, the settling time can be evaluated by using this equation number 3.48. So that is TS equal to the natural logarithm of percentage of error by zeta omega n. Right. So simply natural logarithm of that is percentage of error by t. See, for 2% tolerance error band, settling time t is equal to 40. For 5% tolerance error case, the settling time is 3t. Just keep in mind, all these expressions are helpful while doing the problems. Thank you.